What's this? Kevvl's still playing X2? What is wrong? I thought we were done with that video, man. You gotta play X3 already. Well, crazy person who's crying for no reason, I realized after reviewing an old video of mine, I kinda mentioned I'd do the X-Hunters and forgot about it until recently. Oops. But I am a Kevvl who sticks to his word, so you can sure as hell bet I'm going to do this. For these fights, there is no stage attached. The X-Hunters are all optional bosses. You can fight them in any of the 8 stages, at your whim. We'll be doing them in order of parts. Each one gives a numbered 0 part. So without further ado, I bring you the Counter-Hunters. First up, we're fighting Serges. I think I might have pronounced his name wrong before, but that was an outtake. I hadn't really researched him. It's Serges, or maybe Serges. It comes from a French word, which basically just means wisdom. Think sage. Intelligence. It's his primary role as an X-Hunter. Now, a lot of people think that this guy is actually Dr. Wily. They asked Keiji Inafune, the creator of Mega Man, and his response was basically just, maybe.
I am Serges, and I cannot allow you to stop the unification. It is for the good of all.
Now, in this fight and the next 2 fights with the other X-Hunters, I will be doing a quick cut, because I don't want to say that dialogue each and every time. So, quick cut now. And we're back. He starts by throwing off his cape. You can actually get hurt by that cape if you're, well, stupid. Or jump, something like that. Can you say super pattern? Normally that doesn't happen that much, but it is possible to lock him into that if you have extreme timing. Basically, though, he's got this shield, and you have to penetrate the shield, usually with your first shot or some good timing. My god, that was awesome. I apparently have amazing timing today. This may be the fastest fight yet. He's gone! And he jumped into the air!
You have nearly delayed the inevitable. We will meet again.
And because I did not have a chance to explain his pattern and all, I'm going to try now. Oh my god, that was funny. Actually, you know what? There's just going to be an outtake with me explaining his pattern, because that was just pitiful. Oi, next up, I think we're fighting Violen. Up next, it's time for Violen. Now, despite kind of sounding like my favorite instrument, his name actually comes from the Japanese pronunciation of the French word for violent. And that's what he is, after all. All brawn, no brain. He talks very slow, also.
X, I shall crush you like a tin can.
Now, before we cut to the fight, I would like to mention that I did things a bit differently this time. It was really late at night, and I opted for Post Production Commentary, just recording the fight with no audio, rather than a live recording. You see, after about an hour's worth of not even getting close during practice runs, I didn't expect to succeed. I figured I'd just do live commentary in the morning and try a few shots here and now. What you are about to see is actually my first recording. I have not yet been able to recreate this extreme bout of luck. My god. I was amazed when this happened. You'll see it shortly. I still can't believe I managed this on my first try. But my strategy is the same in all subsequent battles where I tried to recreate it. Basically, you just stand in the corner and pray. That mace ball is insanely random. He does have a few other attacks, though. If he shoots off those finger blasts, then you need to either dodge through them or around them. Through them is usually easier, but you can jump to his other side and be fine. Really, fighting this guy is just luck. You gotta hope and pray that that mace ball will not hit you. Still, it's not nearly as random as, say, Sting Chameleon, but he's difficult. And he's down.
It cannot be. Now the unification.
I am not going to question that. Shut up, me. No one cares.
One
bit.
Yeah, I just said I do not want to question that because I was still amazed.
Now the unification is in jeopardy.
And he gives us zero part number two. Haha. Alright, next up is Agile. Let's go to that. And finally, we're at the last hunter, Agile. His name is probably the easiest to distinguish what it means, since the French word for fast is used the same in English anyway. Now, supposedly this guy has the highest total power statistics of any X-Hunter, and the second highest in the game. If you beat the game, it shows that his power is 9,800 RP, whatever RP stands for, and his speed is 17,800 RP, which is super ironic because that means he's the second easiest boss, in my opinion, with the second highest overall power. Worse still, this guy's supposed to be a military strategist, so he's got brains, brawn, and speed, but so easy. What's up with that? Either way, this fight's gonna be pitiful.
Welcome, X. Your destruction is at hand.
And once again, there will be a shortcut. And we're back. Agile's actually very easy to deal with, as long as you know how to manipulate his pattern, which isn't that hard to manipulate. Stay up, his sword slash will not hit you if you drop down. Make sure to wait for him to attack before you attack him, because he has a tendency to dash rather than attack, which can be sporadic, and it's very hard to avoid if you're not ready for it. So long as you're on the wall, though, he can't hit you with that. I prefer not to dash shot him like I do with most other Mavericks, because it makes you more vulnerable to that dash attack I mentioned earlier. Since he is so easy to manipulate, it's a tedious fight, but it's not a difficult one. If he does somehow manage to catch you with a blade on the bottom of the screen, just dash underneath it, and hope he doesn't dash towards you. Otherwise, just a war of attrition. And not really much of one, anyway. I wonder if he'll do that dash attack. There it goes! And there's dashing under that other blade. So really, easiest of the X-Hunters, which is ironic because he's the fastest one. And usually fast robots are the difficult ones to no damage, because they're designed to do a lot of very weak hits. But this guy? Not.
I may have failed, but you will never live to see zero.
Yeah, and you and your friends all failed. And we get Zero's third part. And we finished off all of the X-Hunters. So, I don't think there's any outtakes that are enjoyable enough. So, I will instead show you how to get to each X-Hunter stage. Short clip in each one, and then a difficulty analysis. Let's move on to that. For Bubble Crab's stage, instead of going into the proper area, you want to follow where the Cantler would have headed if you hadn't killed him quickly enough. I decided to leave him mostly alive for this fight. Just a tail is gone, that'll allow you to drop up, no problem. The door is over there, and you're transported to a little fight. You're plopped out right in front of where Bubble Crab will be. Now, for Crystal Snail's X-Hunter stage, you need to grab this ride armor. Kill that thing, and dash across to here. You need it to blow up these pieces of ice. Oh, come on, let me in. There we go. And then you need to jump up these. You cannot wall hang over here, so you have to use these little platforms. Not too difficult, though. Right in the beginning of the stage, and there's the room. Wire Sponge's X-Hunter stage is actually really easy to get to. When you get to the elevator, instead of going over, just go under. And it's right there. No problem. For Wheel Gator's X-Hunter room, you need to go to the second platform upwards, and as before, ignore those idiots because they have terrible timing, and instead of dropping off here, keep moving upwards to the spike area. Gently, ooh, grab that one up if you want it. And there you are. No problem. For Flame Stag, you need to make use of this Beatron. You'll get to see also what happens when it blows up one of these walls. Duck out of the way at just the right time, and move up. Bam! Boss room. No big deal. Very easy to get to. In Overdrive Ostrich's stage, the boss room is in the very beginning, but you do need a weapon for it. Wheel Gator's weapon. Crack open these blocks. Get yourself a little life if you need it. And boss room. I'm going to ask, is this really necessary for me to show? We've already seen where it is in Magnus Centipede's stage, but what the hell, I'll show you it again. It's right there. Yeah, I made it by mistake last time. Morph Moths is actually kinda hard to get to, but I've found this is the best way. Drop down here like usual, and then dash jump onto the ladder. This will double the power of your shots and allow you to take out these disc boys without any problem. After that, drop onto this area, go up, and gently take out this disc boy with a few dash shots. It may take a while. Come on. Oh. There we go. And from there, dash across. And we're at the boss room. I would like to make a small correction for Crystal Snail's stage. Before, I used Wire Sponge's weapon, but I was alerted that you can actually do it a different way. Observe. Tap the jump button. X has got plenty of room to move. Tapping the hover will give you ample opportunity to keep going, and you'll make it no problem. No need for weapons, you can get it right at the beginning of the stage. Now, difficulty analysis. As you can see, all three hunters are up on the board. I'll be doing them all individually, from least to most difficult. First up, Agile. Agile, you sly dog, you. You get a measly 1 out of 10. Seriously, though, his pattern is just so easy to manipulate. You could probably fight him in your sleep with one hand tied behind your face. Once you learn that his dash attack is hard to avoid from the bottom, you'll learn to stay on the top. You're good. The fight is no problem. Go up, then go down. That's it. Next up, Serges. Now, Serges can cause some issues. He gets a 6 out of 10. I admit, I got pretty lucky in my fight with him, hence why I opted for a little redo, because I was too busy amazed at how good my timing was. I had to do it over. But generally, I've noticed a few things about his pattern. He has a tendency to do 2, 3, or even 6 of those crazy, shooty spin jumps in a row, and having to dodge more than one can really set you off balance. It generally leads to pain. He'll drop mines, and then you're just screwed. But you can sort of prevent him from spin jumping more than once. It seems. You gotta make sure he's in the right spot. If you consider that he can lay his mines in 5 spots, keeping him in between the 2nd and 4th spot, I've noticed it helps for some reason. His pattern is simple, but when he spin jumps over and over, there are problems. I spent probably the longest practicing this guy, because I was trying to figure him out, and this is all I came up with. It's not foolproof, but it seems to work. And finally, Violen. Now, Violen is, as I said before, a total random jerk. I was fully ready and expecting to give him a full 10 out of 10 rating, but I just can't do it. He gets a 9 out of 10 because even though I've only been able to recreate that luck I had once, that's still a lot less than the time it took me to fight Sting Chameleon. It seems I can get a successful run of Violen about 1 in 60 times, as compared to Sting Chameleon, well, that was 128 failures, 1 success. That's about double as hard. By all means, Violen is not easy. He's extremely random, and his Morningstar Maceball has a really mean tendency to just end your run. You can't react to it, it's just so fast and random. But it didn't feel nearly as frustrating in fighting him. I don't know, I think I'm gonna go sacrifice a pair of dice in the almighty name of Number Man for that blessing of the first try. Thank you, random number generator. After that, I'm gonna start working on Mega Man X3, which I cannot wait for. I hope you enjoy that as much as I will. It is my favorite game in the series, and I have been waiting to perfect run that ever since I started X1. Until then, this is Kevvl, signing off. Ciao!